and son, Louisiana firefighters Keith and Wes, share a love for their job and the outdoors.
Wes, have you already lost a striker? Give it to you both.
But while Keith is nearing retirement,
are you kidding me?
He's not yet ready to pass the torch to his son, Wes.
We lost our striker for our Flint Rock, and I'm pretty sure it was him.
Man, you got to quit laying stuff in the sand.
You laid it down.
This is my time to shine.
What about my time? Is it over
your
with?
Your time's been gone.
Been gone?
It's showtime for me, I think.
Showtime for you.
I got social aspect, physical aspect, mental aspect. I feel like I got it all.
You're about as mentally strong as that rock.
Down here in the camouflage, what are your names?
Wes.
Keith, father, son.
You didn't make fire?
No.
I had a problem. The problem is we lost our striker.
We lost it. We searched for it for like an hour. It started out bad.
but we used a rock, and we got our little bowl going with a rock until our flint broke in half. And then it was downhill after.
Yeah. I gotta say, I've used flint a couple of times. It's pretty hard to break one.
We did it.
I'm fixing to play Survivor. I'm fixing to take it to the end, and then boom, I'm on Exile Island. I'm the first out of the chute, me and Val.
You gonna go look for shelter?
Yeah. That ain't the way I had this mapped out. I don't even know my tribe yet. I don't wanna be here.
Let's take a look then.
Mine was blank. Story of my life. I said, well, what'd you get, Val? She kind of hem-hawed around, and if it's got something to do with Val's tribe, more power to her. Because I'm not going back to Val's tribe. I'm going back to my tribe.
You from Louisiana?
Uh-huh. I ain't been no further north than Arkansas.
Really?
I wouldn't know how to act in Massachusetts. I saw that Boston shirt.
Yeah.
And I saw his Cambridge shirt.
Dang.
I tell you what, then, we got something in common.
You're
back there? Me and
Wesley.
No. Yeah. Come to find out, Val's husband's a firefighter. That is going to be a bond. That's going to be a big plus, probably. When I do get back to camp, I'm going to check in with Jeremy, see where he stands, but who knows? I don't know what I'm going to walk into going back there. Worst case, all eight of them hate me. That's the end of my survivor career. I just rejoined my original tribe. First thing we did was a challenge. Boom, won that. And then to come out here and see what they've all got accomplished, looks like they work together. That's a good thing.
Hey, I need to know some names, too. Yeah.
I'm Reed.
Reed.
Julie.
Julie and
I'm
Mary.
Missy.
Didn't really know what to expect. And I kind of worked my way into this tribe. Since I've been gone, I'm just going to try to slip in, fit in a little bit. Just now really figuring out their names. I knew Jeremy, and that was about it.
Yeah, I wanted to talk to you because I owe you anyways for taking care of you. I owe you.
It wasn't no chore.
But I owe you. I pulled you out.
Yeah.
And I'm going to get you right back in. You know what I mean? And you're in.
I got Jeremy kind of halfway on my side, I would think. He's a firefighter. I'm a firefighter. I mean, fire department's a brotherhood. Now the other, seven? I have no idea about. Give me a day or two and we'll figure all this out. Drew's the big sleeper. If my son was acting like Drew, you probably don't want to know. I probably can't say it on camera because I'd get in one of them little, but we still spank. We still whoop, whatever you want to call it, in the South.
Ty fight. I like to see it. I got 30 years on him, but I say off pretty close.
You're emotional again.
Yeah, well, I mean, you see him coming along, as a young man, shooting.
You're proud of him.
Oh, yeah, heck yeah.
Do you guys share this kind of emotion typically, Wes?
No. Not at all. I don't see this emotion. I mean, I've only seen him like it when my great-grandpa died and his grandfather died.
Hey, we're good. We're good.
Josh is on one side of the fire, I'm on the other side of the fire. And there won't be no spooning going on up here tonight either, so.
Oh, heck yeah.
I just don't see many Joshes in Louisiana. The other day on Exile Island, I got a clue that there was an idol over here by the well. So I went up here and digged around, kicked around to see if I couldn't find it.
Ooh.
I dug around the sand for about 30 minutes, and
also I'm wasting my time.
Kid.
Unfortunately, looks like I'm a day late and a dollar short. Looks like somebody's already been through there. So I'm thinking I might have got beat to the punch.
Guys, here's the deal. I've got a clue, and somebody I kind of poked around just a few minutes ago, and I didn't find nothing. The only other person that could find it is the person that went to Exile Island before me.
Okay.
And that's Jeremy. So Jeremy's got an idol. Keep that in mind. Idols are important in this game. Having one limb is a good thing to have around. And I said, all right, well, we'll go back. You know, maybe I wasn't due north or seven steps. So I just poked and prodded around a little more. It had done been found, but obviously not. Matter of fact, it just kind of jumped out at me, kind of scared me. I'm probably not going to tell anybody that I have the idol, because the last thing I need is a target on my back. I'm not a brain surgeon, but if everybody thinks Jeremy has it, that could be good for me.
Keith comes back from exile, tells everybody that I have an idol. So I said, Keith, why don't you come to me and say, hey, do you have an idol? We're aligned.
I was looking for the idol, and I didn't find the idol. I assumed, might have been wrong, I assumed Jeremy had beat me to the punch.
And I'm in your alliance, so why don't you come to me?
Because you go to somebody else, and they go to somebody else, and before you know
we could have kept it between me and you.
Jeremy, come on now.
We could.
It doesn't happen like that in this
game. Why not?
It just doesn't. If I say, okay, Jeremy, I got an idol, first thing on his head, let's put his name down.
Not if we're in an alliance. That's what an alliance is, Keith.
But it's more than two people, Jeremy.
Well, we could have two people aligned and have a sub-alliance with everybody else. We could have done that.
Sub-alliance, okay.
We could have done that, Keith.
That's a new one on me.
It's not a new one in Survivor.
Keith, one of the things Jeremy seems to be saying is, when you're in alliance with somebody, you don't betray them. You keep that together.
I don't call this betrayal.
Well, you started kind of pitting people against Jeremy. That's what where everybody went,
whoa. That wasn't the way it was meant to be. After we lost the little challenge, seems like these three couples would be gunning to get me. That's just a free vote. They wouldn't lose none of their loved ones. Keith would be gone. Everything would be good.
That was crazy, wasn't it?
So does anybody feel they're back up to what they weighed when we started the game?
I feel pretty good about that, yeah.
But the three couples, one don't like the other, one, you know, that could be real good for me. I mean, we'll see tonight at Tribal. You could have let me know. When I saw my name come up twice in Tribal, I said, what in the world? Are you kidding me? My name wasn't in the plan. Did I miss the memo? Or what if Dale would have voted for me? It would have been 3-3.
We would have done a revote. We all would have voted for Dale.
Dale was gone. We don't have to lie.
I'm telling you, you're a big part of this.
I think we can make this happen. But when stuff like that happens, it makes you feel like I ain't too sure. It was Missy and Baylor that voted for me. And they give me some lame excuse. Well, I need somebody that stays loyal. Shoot, I'm done with y'all. I'll leave you hanging high and dry. I'm excited to play with Wes. It'd been 16 days, and yeah, it was good to see him.
She was born, I was like, I got divorced.
So I could care less about Missy, Baylor.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, Josh. First person to tell me that. I've been talking to him all morning.
Wesley's birthday today. Matter of fact, I woke up this morning and forgot all about it, and then Josh wished him happy birthday before I did.
All right, here you go. Happy birthday.
There you go.
Roast your crab.
You got one, for real. Don't ever say your dad didn't provide for you.
Enjoy your crab in Nicaragua. Yeah, I did forget for a minute, but no big deal. I finally remembered. Wish him happy birthday, and everything's good. Happy birthday right here on the beach.
Wes is out. Keith wins. First, individual immunity.
And yeah. Crazy.
Dude, that was
crazy.
You blew it!
I can't even beat your old man. Thanks.
Keith, come on over.
All right.
First individual immunity win. Safe tonight at Tribal Council. Cannot be voted out of this game.
All right. As long as you keep burping, I guess you're okay. Wesley's a good kid. He ain't been in jail yet, you know.
But he does make some mistakes.
I can just give him my words of wisdom about all I can do.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Wandering off?
Ugh. That's my boy overloading over there.
Whoop!
It'll pass, man. Just breathe.
Oh, who the heck raised him? I'm sitting right here. Yeah, I don't, his mama. I don't know. God, dog.
You two jump ship quick. John's been lying to me for 18 days.
We just haven't lined up.
Mitchie's been lying to him about 17 days.
Part of the game.
Hey, roger that. That's the way I feel. It didn't go our way tonight. John and Jacqueline flipped over there again with them, and we're in a bad place. They could pick us off one at a time. As soon as you step back here, the couples deal was over, because that didn't last long with you. Remember the word couples?
Not when you jumped over with your son like that.
My son is my couple. I have the idol. Thing about that's playing it at the right time to maybe get one of them out.
I think you're trying to pin it on me when it's really about you.
I think everything changes after the merge.
I don't know about all that. Maybe I can tell them to vote me off. They all put my name down. I play the idol. Done. I've had it with John. I've had it with Missy. That might not be a bad idea. Because it's getting to crunch time now.
Hey, I tell you, somebody broke into my bag.
I mean, I've got the idol, but now everybody knows I have the idol. The clue and everything was wrapped up with the idol. The idol was in my blue jean pants. The clues and everything was in that blue bag. And it's now gone.
There's a thief up here somewhere.
I mean, that's my stuff. I don't go through your stuff. I don't expect people to go through my stuff, but different people got different values, I guess.
We're up creek.
So word might be out that Keith's got the idol, and it might come in play sooner than later.
Here's the deal. That other alliance is convinced that you and Wes have an idol between the two of you. What they want to do with the next vote is split the vote between you and Wes. So they will think they have four votes going to one of you and three votes going to another.
They're including you and Alec?
Yes, but Alec and I are going to vote with you and Wes. That's my plan. What are your thoughts?
Yeah.
Are you cool with that?
I'm cool with that. That's a good plan. We can play all four and get John out there ringleader, which I don't care much for to begin with. And I still won't have to play the idol. Hopefully.
As long as we just trust each other for this one vote, we can make a huge change in the game.
Nat, there's your team sitting right over there.
So, Keith, you're saying Natalie's the only one of her group still up there?
Yeah. It shows me that Natalie's fighting for her team, and the other three of us are fighting for our lives.
So then what is it about your son that made him drop?
Yeah, Wes, I don't know, maybe a food weakness. I'll have a little father-son with him after we get through with this.
I ate 58 chicken nuggets in 5 minutes and won the eating contest once.
So it makes you wonder then, do Wes and Keith have an idol? Are they sharing it? Or what really is happening here?
Keith, it doesn't get any more direct than that.
It doesn't. You're exactly right. See how easy that was? And then all of a sudden, it's bam. Idols are everywhere. Idols are everywhere. I say stick to the plan. You know, at this point, that's all I can say.
Wow, John, stick to the plan. This is a hidden immunity idol. Any votes cast for John will not count.
Here you go, Jeff. You play it.
Yeah.
And he opened it.
How do you know it's real?
Just taking a chance.
This too is a hidden immunity idol. Any votes cast for Keith will not count. John does not count. John does not count. John does not count. Keith does not count. Keith does not count. John does not count. Keith, nobody with any votes. Ninth person voted out and the third member of our jury. Wes, you need to bring me your torch.
Keith, does he have the touch? He does. Keith wins.
individual immunity.
Yeah. Golly.
29 days in, given the way things have been going, I'm guessing this feels pretty good right now.
This comes in hand. Yeah, given the way things have been going. Man, where do we stand?
Well, you know, right now, it's like at the bottom, it's either you or Alex tonight, right?
Oh, yeah.
I feel like you deserve to be here more than Alex. But I think you're really scary on immunity challenges. That's why the decision is probably...
Oh, me?
Yeah, because, come on, this Alex is useless.
Yeah, he is.
You don't have to worry about him winning, you know?
I was real close again to getting the necklace today. And I could kick myself right now. I needed it. I needed it. Everybody knows I need it. And it's a bad feeling.
It's burned me yesterday, and it's burning me again today that they're just laid up over there.
And y'all are taking them to the inn? Y'all could send a message just like that. I mean, take Alex out or take me out, but you're going to have to eventually take each other out.
We're tied. 3 votes Alec, 3 votes Keith, 1 vote left. 11th person voted out, and the 5th member of our jury. Alec. Need to bring me your torch.
How the votes worked, I was supposed to vote for you last night, and I voted for Alec, and that switched the whole thing up.
And you about had it with Alec?
Yeah, because Alec was just obsessed with John for no reason, you know?
I got it. Man, it seems like I just keep squeaking by, squeaking by, squeaking by.
They don't know that it was we that I did that. So, me, you, Missy, and Baylor, we gotta be tight.
Maybe I have somebody now. Can you believe that? 30 days into this baby, and I've got Nat? Good grief. What could happen after that? Who knows?
I feel like you deserve to be in the game more than Alec Longer anyway.
I'm glad you do.
Don't pay those two any mind.
Well, you mean Mr. and Miss Prom Queen or Homecoming Queen? Don't worry about that. I don't know what it is. I see some goobers on the end.
Some what? Goobers. Oh, nuts.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Mm.
Slow down now, Baylor. Don't fill up on that rabbit food. Don't get like Wes.
He's gonna die when he sees that you're at the spa.
Yeah, it's a girl thing, but as long as this food's here, it's a guy thing.
Yep.
I've never had a spa day or spa food. Turned out not too bad. Hey, that looks like a piece of bacon.
Spa food's not so bad.
Heck no. I ate about as much as I could, and then I went on to the shower. Knocked the funk off of me that 30-something days I hadn't bathed.
I come out here looking like George Clooney.
Then it was off to the massage.
Oh. Well, every now and then she hits the right spot. Oh, like right there. Oh, leave. Oh, my goodness. That's my bony rib cage. Uh-oh.
Keith at a spa was pretty dang funny.
I can't breathe.
And I hadn't seen that side of Keith before.
I don't get to get around to many of these in Louisiana.
I had a realization of, like, Keith's kind of cool.
Do you feel the knots in your shoulders?
I think so. Half of them might be my bones. I've never had a massage before. I mean, don't tell nobody about all that, you know. I don't want the guys at the fire station knowing I'm going to masseuse him, you know, all this other extracurricular stuff.
You might have to roll me off this baby.
But, man, I've been rejuvenated, and I've got 4, 5, 6 days left. I can take this on out no problem now.
Good grief.
Just bored, John. I'll tell you. The plan is to split votes. If John plays his idol, we'll vote out Jacqueline. If he doesn't play his idol, we re-vote and vote John, and John goes home. Getting out John at this point would be dream come true.
It's tribal night, and if all goes to plan, Mr. All-American or Miss USA is going home, and I'll be sitting here with 5.
But that's the plan. We're pretending like we're all voting for you, so at tribal, don't act crazy, but just act like, you know, depressed that you're going home.
I think I can trust this bunch. You know, if I can't, I'm a goner.
12th person voted out and the 6th member of our jury, John.
Keith wins reward! An advantage in the next immunity challenge.
The little note said read in private, so I snuck off and read it. You have earned an advantage in the next immunity challenge. A challenge table has been delivered to a private spot at your camp. You can practice for as long as you want, but once you stop, you are finished. Good grief. It had a few more clues, you know, telling me how the challenge works. Jeff wasn't there, nothing to fill me in. Oh, it goes like that? I mean, it took me a little while to figure it out.
start it like that.
The challenge table is sort of like foosball. I got four handles, and you just pass a ball to a paddle, over an obstacle to another paddle. Complete that three times. Bam, necklace around your neck. Whoa.
Bitch.
I'm gonna stay here and practice because I need that necklace tomorrow. This is a big advantage, believe me. There does come a point in the fire service where it's stay and die or jump out the window. It's called flashover. This room's fixing to flash over, and you better do something quick like. It's to the point now, I'm on the hot seat, but I think maybe I'm not flashed over yet. I'm probably gonna practice till dark. I'm ready to go tackle this baby and get that necklace.
When the young...
Your concentration ain't as good as it was when you first started. I don't know why that's so hard for me right there. I ought to have this by now, but good grief, man, I'm going mentally. All right. Whoa. All I can do right now, win challenges and go for that necklace.
I'm losing focus.
Keith wins! Individual immunity guaranteed a spot in the final four.
You never got it going down?
Yeah, really?
Nobody got a ball?
No.
Really?
That's what, just a little bit of practice.
And you're good with balls, Keith.
I'm good with balls. Coming back to camp wasn't too bad. I don't know. Man. All right. Yeah, I ought to have this by now, right? Your mind goes on the 37th or 8th day or whatever. Okay. All right, here we go. Coming back to camp. After the immunity challenge, wasn't too bad. Tonight probably won't be too hard. I mean, Jacqueline knows she's going right up there to the jury.
13th person voted out and the 7th member of our jury, Baylor.
You mean plead my case right now, or you're who I need to be talking to, Jack? She's the power, she's the man.
Whoever wears the necklace got the power.
Yeah. Day 38, you try to make a pitch to get to the million. And day 39, you're pitching why you deserve the million. I'm far from the million right now. I've got to get in the final three. I'm thinking you got a better chance with me and Nat instead of Missy and Nat. Missy's gonna get a lot of votes. She's gonna get the sympathy vote for her ankle. Some. She's got Baylor already.
Yeah. That makes sense.
I give Jacqueline my pitch. If Jacqueline gets rid of Missy, she's got a better chance with me in the three than Missy. Hopefully she'll visualize that and see. That's all I can say. It's in y'all's hands.
14th person voted out and the 8th and final member of our jury.
All right.
Keith, need to bring me your torch. Keith, Travis spoke. Time for you to go.
See y'all.
Hi, Keith.